Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, it is with the greatest honor that I am fortunate to address you today on the occasion of another Christmas. Christmas is born in the strongest foundations of our Christian faith, a tradition that has sustained us for hundreds of years. This is a time of the year when we renew our commitment to our faith and our family. The essence of the season is embraced in the phrase, peace on earth and goodwill to all mankind. As leader of a political party which is seeking to lead this country, this is the message we want to bring to you as well. We also want to bring a reassurance that in a time of stress and strife, our faith sustains us as we hope on and hope for greater and better things. We observe Christmas 2008 at a time of great uncertainty, but at the same time, a time of great opportunity. There is an uncertainty born out of an unstable local and international financial climate. From a blood-soaked national earth that has devoured 23 members of our families who are not here to celebrate another Christmas with us. We pray for all those who have been touched by this pain. For them, an empty chair at the dinner table, an open spot on the veranda is memory of their days of darkness. But just as one bright star led three wise men to the Christ child, there is a light on our horizon. The spirit of petition and divisions cannot be stifled by fear. In fact, it is aroused by hope and a solid attitude that we will become better. And for those of us who are still here this Christmas, there is the opportunity that we can individually and collectively work to change this society, to make it better than it was when those who are missing had left us. For when the road seems steepest, our enduring Christian faith sustains us. We believe in a God who came to us some 2,000 years ago as the Christ child, and who ensured that death has no victory and the grave has no sting. Christmas is about rebirth and about salvation. And it's also at a time when we can look forward to a new year, which signals a new beginning and a new promise. At this time of the year, we do not wallow in our hurt. We rejoice in the name of the Christ child, in our successes, and in what's possible. Christmas provides the template for us to close the gap in our communities, to reach out to the less fortunate, and to look out for our neighbors. Christmas provides a template for us to come together as a nation that prays and plays together. Indeed, this is a time of great merriment, made even more so since it is punctuated by the carnival season. As we do, we must pray for each other's safety, and we must preserve our individual dignity. Whatever we do, we must do so in moderation. We must not do anything we would be ashamed of or regret tomorrow. On behalf of my wife and my two children, I want to wish each and every member of our nation a happy Christmas and a bright and prosperous New Year. Forgive me if I take the time off to specially wish the people of constituency number 4 a special good wish. These are the people I seek to represent in Parliament in the new year. And these are the people that have motivated me and inspired me throughout this entire year and in my many years. I get up every morning not just thankful for a new day, but refreshed in the understanding that the opportunities this life has offered me, I must pay back to the community that has molded me. There is no individual success unless there is collective achievement. The Christ child, whom we celebrate this season, was and is the ultimate community leader. He was born, lived, died, was raised from the dead, so that all of us could have a second chance. His mission was not to friend the powerful, but to champion the cause of the least fortunate among us. These are ideals. Even in our very imperfect state, we must strive to achieve as the considered leaders in our society. I want to express my appreciation for the many advice and criticisms that you, the people, have given me over this past year. You have taught me so much, and it has made me a better person. Let me also pay tribute to my team in the People's Action Movement and all of their families who have had to endure the many hours we have had to spend away from home. This time of year, I also want to send out glad tidings to the Prime Minister and the members of his government. There would be a time and place where we would vigorously debate our differences, for which there are many. But today, we want to wish you the best the season has to offer. We pray that every member of our community will be safe this Christmas season, and that there will be joy in every heart. Once again, Merry Christmas and a bright and prosperous New Year.